you want me to, what? Oh, okay, let me just fix up myself and make sure me look good. Action! Okay, hi, hello Saints. This is Pasta Phrank'Land here again. I know, it's been such a long time since we see me blood up Saints. How you doing? Good. Good, that God bless your soul, hallelujah. I just want to tell you a little story about what happened to Pasta. Pasta, almost never make it to 2011 altogether. But you know what? Through God's grace and mercy, me make it. You know why? Because I pray like a blood up saint. You go. I speak tongues like a blood up saint. But go. I even lift up my hand like a blood up. Lift up your hand if you know what I'm talking about, blood up saints. So let me hear a hallelujah. Yeah. I felt that in my heart. You know what? Let me tell you something about what I do. I was walking this journey. And one night I was sleeping. Sleeping in my bed. Do a broadcast to the world.
Just
hurry up and make tea, man.
You want something to eat?
Yeah, okay.
You're hungry?
Yeah, just make me some ackee and sausage, man. Come on now.
This is
me a grown boy.
Correct.
In Jesus' name. Still there, man. How come you take so long, man?
But what are you talking about?
I was just supposed to just tell my story and my testimony to the people there, man. And no, all of a sudden you dress up, like say it's about you.
Listen, me now come on, brad. Your son come in a me duster.
Alright, see, you know what the filmer was saying. You have to make sure you look right in the camera.
We know how to broadcast.
Look
right. We know how to broadcast. You never know, say we was in Oliver when I was 12. What?
You know, one. And when you fall on your face, don't call me.
Call Jesus. For three, two, action.
Like I was saying before,
it's such a horrible thing. I don't know how to share it to you.
But one night, I think back in March or April or May or June, July, I was sleeping. I was sleeping good. I saw the vision of the Holy Spirit.
Saints of God, it hurt me to sit here today because I don't like to talk about this subject a lot. Listen, just nobody eat the food off, alright? And that's a take for everybody. Good. Saints, like I was saying in particularly like 2 minutes ago, I don't like to talk about this subject because it hurt my heart. No matter how you see me treat Cledius away, me treat him rough because he's rough, you know?
You treat me like say I'm Lucifer or something like that.
Listen, if he was Lucifer, we would live with you.
Like say I don't have no feeling.
Me a broadcast, you know? Me a broadcast.
Sorry.
Jesus. Sorry, I have a little sniffle on my nose. I don't want to talk about this subject because Cledius is the love of my life.
Mm-hmm. So she say.
Me love him down to cook food, to ackee and sausage, to bummy. You know when it's crispy on the outside and saucy on the inside? I saw brother Phrank'Land's tea. Pasta Phrank'Land is tough on the outside and soft on the inside.
You are nice.
Listen. I am on Weight Watchers. Don't tempt me. God.
Take it. And you know what? Was a good dream that. Just stop it, man. Me trying to tell the people them the story. It was a good dream. You know those good dreams when you wake up you feel nice? When I wake up I feel nice. And I take my time and I try and get out my bed and me drop. And I say, what the hell? I get up again and I drop up. I tell you no word of a lie. Me too.
I feel like earthquake.
Shut up, man. This is serious.
Him wake me up one night, yeah? Saints of God, him wake me up after me sleep. And I was dreaming about Idris Albert. And me say, what you wake me for? wake me up because I was so in tune with my sleep.
I woke you up because I was speaking in tongues.
Him wake me up because he say, Sister Phrank'Land, me do they at me. Me do they at me.
I don't sound like that.
Stop me too they at me. Me too they at me. Is that better?
Me too heavy like Jamaica. No word of a lie. And you know what I said no. The devil is a liar. And so is his sister and brother-in-law. And I start praying. Roko ka teke doko toko toko. Twist up, bami, bami. And you know what happened? My toe didn't get better. It didn't get better.
Yes, me say, alright, well. Go put some ice on the tar. What's the big deal? He said, no, Cincinnati, me try to turn up. And me can't turn up. Lord Jesus, me throw the job off.
Just call me this story, my man. Jesus, see if you're a pilot, me, man.
If I wasn't a Christian, you see?
Mm-hmm, what? Sometimes no. I wonder if you're a Christian.
Ask Cincinnati, did my toe get better?
Let me tell you something, yeah? As soon as them boys tell me, him throw the at him, I say, look, you better go to the doctor, you know? Go to the doctor, because...
I don't need no doctor.
Let me tell you something.
Not a pastor.
You see, God can work miracles, right? But, you see Bob Marley? You know that big time secular singer about no woman not cry?
It's not secular. It's gospel.
Birds and wires. And all them things that boy there, him too.
No,
man,
I don't receive it.
Oh God.
I don't receive
him
that.
Him too feel no more than the way I play football at the ball ground. And let me tell you something, the boy dead. Him dead. You know why?
No.
Him too.
No. No. That's not my. No. No.
So we say, all right. No better cry. You're a big man. Come on. So. We get up out of the bed and I say, you know what, you need to go to the doctor. I say, no, me not go to the doctor. Doctor will kill you off.
Because I believe in the God. Go on.
Mm-hmm. God give all of us gifts and talents. And the way I look at it is, you need to use your gifts and your talents. So, if a doctor can make you better, go to the doctor.
So, you know what I've been seeing? So, Pastor said, you know what, I'm gonna fast and pray for 40 days and 40 nights. You know, say, me not like give up food, but I know that I serve a God. I serve a God that righteous and sit high and look down low upon me big belly and me big toe.
He only fast for about 2 hours.
Well, I try.
I said, Pastor Phrank'Land, go back to sleep. Let me give you some Cersei tea and some Tylenol. Go back to sleep. And in the morning, we go to the doctor.
Elisha tell. She box me and say, nobody have me, ma'am. Me need to sleep. I get my beauty sleep. Yes, God. And I shave up every inch of my belly fat for the fast. Because I was believing that God is able. Somebody shout out, God is able. That's great. Hallelujah. Me. Yeah, I love you. Scooby-dooby-dog. Got the gig and the wood.
Wilma! So, I give him some Cersei tea. And I give him some Tylenol. And I say, go to sleep. And tomorrow I go to the doctor. Pastor Phrank'Land, they fight me. Me not go to no doctor. You can't make me.
I just believe my God.
Listen. We're going to the doctor. Get on your drawers on your backside. We're going to the doctor. Good. Him said, we're going to go on 40 days of fasting. Me not go to the doctor tomorrow. Let's go on 40 days of prayer and fasting. I said, Pastor Phrank'Land, the last time we decided to go on fasting, you almost eat me hair off of my head. No bother with it. So we just go on a 2 hours fasting, which is really just from breakfast to lunch. Well, breakfast or snack.
I hear that. I hear his voice. I say, clear to me. Go to your church and ask them for $1,000. And you know what?
I didn't do it. You know why? Because the people them cheap. My God, they hold up on the money. Like say, it's not.
Listen. I know God that, you know. I know God tell him say go ask for money. Because
it was.
Me tell him say go a doctor. God. You want a piece of apple?
Yeah, man.
All
come
right.
Cut me a piece of man. But wash it good. And could I get a piece of cheese with that? The Jamaican cheese. Thank God you. That.
And then we pray. Him go to church and him say, saints, me need on a prayer. And him prostrate, belly flop on the floor at the altar. And I said, God, if you be God, if you be, I want to work a miracle. Because no matter how tough I seem on the outside, I want my husband to be here until Jesus returns.
That's what happens when you have a spiritual wife.
Me said, come out of the brat.
You want dumpling? And you want your festival? I'm just saying.
Come out of the shot.
I'm just, you don't want fish. Alright, fine. Me make the festival yourself.
Make sure you add baking soda to it. I mean baking powder. I don't want it to be flat.
Let me get it, man. You don't worry about me. You know what happened? The cheap people, they give me the $1,000. And I spend it on Bami. And you know what? I didn't mean to spend it on Bami anymore. But you know what? God just moved in my spirit again. I think it was a burp. But you know what? I felt him and I bought the Bami. And my intention was to give it to the lost souls and preach to them and tell them that Jesus loved them and give them hot and warm and crispy Bami. But it didn't work out that way because I'm off the Bami.
I said, God, work a miracle because I don't want my husband gone leave me.
Me no, you mean ticket?
I don't want him leave me. I don't want him gone because I love him. God know me love that man. He's so big because love him bigness because he's so big like
Simba. Me love you too.
Like Simba Buttermuff. Hippo Buttermuff.
I go to Florence, Dr. Florence, and he do all his tests. Well, he sit down with me and he say, well, you know, Pastor Phrank'Land. He said, Pastor Phrank'Land. Actually, he called me Mr. Phrank'Land. I don't like Mr. Phrank'Land. I'm not Mr. Phrank'Land. I'm anointed and appointed by the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
And you only call me by my only name. That's
Hallelujah.
Pastor Phrank'Land. Pastor with a star and then a Frank and Alan. God.
Give me a minute because we're getting emotional. Give me a minute. Let me comfort myself because I don't like people to see me in my unprofessional state. Since when Pastor Phrank'Land was sleeping, you don't know this. I'm gonna share this with you because I believe that you and I connect on a certain level as a first lady to disciple. Right. He was sleeping, snoring as usual.
Tell the truth, that's the end of the day. I don't snore.
I don't think they wear so clean the blankets.
He come and he want to come poke me with things. I said, no. That's intrusive. The only person poke me is Jesus, which is Holy Spirit. Thank you.
And me.
Jesus, that's another video, God.
Me go to my couch right here. Right on this couch right here. We put down my little prayer pillar. And we pray. We pray till my voice off. I couldn't even say hallelujah. Because I was so off. Saints of God, I pray. Jesus. Hallelujah. I feel that when I feel that one.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
I feel.
She pray. So let me just interject you. You have a woman that pray for you.
Jesus.
That fast for
Hallelujah.
You. Men hold on to her tight. You know what is true. Let me just sleep on this first before we take all these tests. I need to get my spirit right for the next level of glory.
Oh,
hallelujah.
God. You never sleep good at all.
No, me never sleep. Jesus.
The belly roll upon me every time. The type of going to go for 50 years to the street.
Shut up, me mama. because I had a dream and I think it was a prophecy from Jesus himself. I was in a room. It all looked so sterile and nasty. And I hear a voice, I thought it was God. God himself was, I thought it was God calling me, you know. It wasn't God. It was Dr. Florence. And him come, and him have him eyes big like this. Big like Jamaica. Big like red snapper fish. And him come, and he said, Pastor Phrank'Land. I said, yes. He said, Pastor Phrank'Land. I said, yes. It's time for your checkup. And he came with a needle big like my head. My head big, you know. I wake up in a cold sweat. And I realize God is able, and I went down on my knees. And I went back to the doctor.
Yeah, but I dropped my tears, water up on the shirt, we just get it dry clean.
Son, I go back to the doctor, and him joke me 5 times in one thigh, and then 5 times in the other thigh, Jesus. And then him do something in the head, and then he rub something upon my chest, and he write something upon my nipple. And then I said, no, that's it. That's all it is you're doing today. In this place. How many weeks was it before me get the test back?
About two and a half.
It felt like 18 weeks, child of God.
Child of God. All joking aside, I was very nervous because the long time I know Cleanius, I'm trying to. Him chong like tough dog.
Like bulldog. They call me bulldog when I didn't serve God.
And now they call him me bulldog because him just look like a bulldog.
Rafa Bakotada.
When him opened up him files.
Jesus.
I was trying to take a glimpse of the paper, but my glasses was too dark. And say it. He said, negative!
No! God, you're real, God!
Negative! Across the board! Send your showers down, Lord! Send your waterfalls from
heaven! Send it down! All of it!
God, I thank you, I praise you, I glorify you, because it was negative across the board.
Negative!
Nothing in his nipples.
Hey!
Nothing in his thighs.
Doctor Nanati can't cut.
Nothing in his balls.
No!
Hallelujah!
Nothing in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah!
I'm just gonna worship God. No, I'm gonna worship God. I don't even move yourself.
Oh,
it's time for me to worship.
The mama is still on the fire. Excuse me.
Hey, shut up. Read this screen there. I can't see. I want me to
It's
laugh.
Talking about prostrate
cancer.
No man, you must pronounce everything. No, put no extra in it. Prostrate.
If you need to get your prostrate cancer,
you need to get your prostrate check.
It's a pronounced pronounced straight.
You don't know if you read. We come from Jamaica, nobody embarrass me, nobody.
I read patois. That mamala.
You need to get your prostate check.
Check. If you're after 50.
40.
48. 40. You're supposed to get your prostate check up. That's in the tester.
They want to check your balls.
Testicular.
Just a ball.
Balls, here we are.
Basketballs, golf ball, grapefruit balls, any balls, every balls.
Yes, every balls.
You're gonna get a check, the ball.
I don't know about what you chat about. All I'm saying is, hold on, that if you want more information, go to your doctor, because I'm not a doctor, but I know the doctor of our doctors.
But he is Pastor Phrank'Land.
Yeah.
PhD.
Boo.
For God. Hallelujah.
Boo. Oh.
Yes.
Get your prostate check every year after 40 years of age because they don't want to have no weird shaped balls walking around.
I remember things. God loves you. Pasta loves you.
Pasta hurt no man, the food they get cold, you know. Me no like to eat cold, okay, man. It tastes nasty.
Like I was saying, pasta love you. God love you. And have a wonderful day.
And Caraman, nobody come on my table because you still not get none of my bummy. Go away with your tear up socks. Mm-hmm. Your brief probably tear up. Get your balls check.
I'm not.